Thank you, Susan, and thank you, ICCF, for putting together this panel and this briefing. At AWF, we'd like to express our gratitude to Senator Coons and Senator Portman for their continued leadership in combating wildlife trafficking. Our achievements and progress made on this issue could not be possible without the US government's leadership, commitment, and support. My name is Didi Wamukoya. I'm the Wildlife Law Enforcement Manager at African Wildlife Foundation, and I oversee AWF's Counter Wildlife Trafficking Program. AWF has been working on the continent for the past 60 years, conserving Africa's wildlife. This year, African Wildlife Foundation came up with a strategic vision 2030 that is going to guide us for the next 10 years, guide our interventions in wildlife conservation in Africa. One of the objectives of this Vision 2030 is to conserve Africa's wildlife in situ and reduce poaching and trafficking as major causes of wildlife decline. Under this Vision 2030, we have a 10-year counter wildlife trafficking action plan to guide and focus AWF's efforts on combating illegal wildlife trade. And the overarching goal of this counter wildlife trafficking action plan is to reduce poaching and trafficking of Africa's wildlife species. AWF welcomes continued support from the US government through the End Wildlife Trafficking Act. This will significantly help reduce wildlife trafficking and unlawful exploitation of wildlife resources by focusing on priority landscapes, sites, spots, and movement routes. Because wildlife trafficking is linked to organized crime, severe corruption, violence, and instability in parts of Africa, AWF believes that its interventions will contribute to saving species and improving the socioeconomic well-being of the countries across the continent where we work. Thank you, Susan, and back to you.